let's add a service worker to the Wizard project and start messing around with these requests. To make things easy, the project already contains a script file at public js sw index.js, and it's currently empty. So let's add a quick console log. The build system picks this up, and the final result is served at sw.js at the root of the server. The extra code here is the output of Babel, which the script runs through. Babel lets you use some of the newer JavaScript features, but I'm going to stick with ES5. But if you feel like writing newer JavaScript, go ahead. As we talked about before, the service worker receives events. Let's add a listener for one of these, fetch. When the user navigates to a page within your service worker's scope, it controls it. The network request for its HTML goes to the service worker and triggers a fetch event. But not only that, you also get a fetch event for every request triggered by that page. CSS, JavaScript, images, you get a fetch event for each, even if they're requests to another origin. And we can inspect them with JavaScript. So in my fetch event, I'm going to log event.request. To find out what kind of information is in that object, click through to the next lesson. That was me trying to build up some dramatic tension. I mean, event.request, it's clearly going to be information about the request. Or is it? Yes, it is.